A very good morning to all the participants. Okay, and my lecture today is focused on the applications of mathematics in real life. Okay. So I'll be discussing the applications focused on the algebra, complex numbers, and theory of equations. Okay. Bala sir, is it audible? Hello?
Very much, sir.
Okay. So let me give you the outline of the entire presentation. So we'll just at the very outset we will see some of the real life applications of mathematics, a few slides on that, and then we will discuss some of the applications of algebra, and then application of complex numbers and theory of equations. So in yesterday's lecture there were a few questions which were raised on the complex numbers. So I hope with my knowledge, whatever I have gained, so I would definitely try my best to clear to give you a philosophical definition of complex number, and to give you a brief understanding about those concepts. And I would also touch the theory of equations and different research applications which we have done, and I would just discuss all those problems. So we are living in a COVID-19 era. So for some, this COVID-19 situation is an opportunity, and for some it is a threat. So it depends upon the person how he pursues this particular situation. So let us now look into this COVID-19 from the mathematical perspective. Okay. So now you are seeing, we know that there are many real-time applications available for face recognition. So people were telling that the face recognition is a solved problem. However, due to COVID-19, the face recognition problem has seen a new dimension. So we can see here the second image which I have shown here is that the person is almost, she's wearing a cap and a mask and a goggle. And this person is wearing a mask and a cap, and we can see that his face is totally invisible. And doing a face recognition in such a scenario during the COVID-19 is a very, very challenging issue. And now another important issue is that, see, it is not only face recognition, but also seeing the detecting the temperature of the person. So you can see these examples. So this also shows, recognizes the face and also shows what is the body temperature of this person. So how this is possible? This is possible by using mathematics, okay, by using the technology. And you can see that, see here, the third example which I have put it is that, so there is, due to COVID-19, there is a lot of statistics. There is a lot of data that is being generated. Even we have done one simple work on predicting the risk of COVID-19 using a mobile app. So we have employed a lot of mathematics in solving this particular problem. So now we can see that here there are a lot of analysis, lot of processing is required. So all these applications are possible as a method, because mathematics is behind, which is actually the driving force for these kind of bigger and larger applications. So I would talk about all those few. I have two slides on data science. I would tell that how this mathematics also, the knowledge of mathematics helps you in actually solving many real life problems. So let us begin the applications of algebra. Okay, the human life or human learning begins with algebra. So when a child is 2 years or 3 years or 4 years, the child is sent to the kindergarten, and the first thing which the child is taught is the counting. So he starts learning 1, 2, 3, and he starts to arrange different blocks, and he also tries to understand what are the different shapes. He would try to, and you can see this example on the right side. See, when you have the problem of building blocks, now yesterday Nagbhushan sir was telling that the automatic detection of, like, he was talking about the problem of jigsaw. Okay, you are fixing one object into the another object. So the child, when it is 2 or 3 years old, it tries to do the same thing. It tries to detect the convexity and it tries to detect the concavity of the objects, and then it tries to insert the right object into the right place. So all these things is possible because we are already started learning algebra. And also, moreover, we can see that the drawing different objects, different figures, right? We do some painting kind of thing. We draw different objects and also choose different colors. How this is possible? This is possible with the knowledge of, directly or indirectly, the knowledge of algebra. And also, we can see all these means all these stages of our life, it prepares us, okay, for learning more advanced algebra. So I think this example yesterday, sir gave you, Nagbhushan sir gave you this example, that how the ball is thrown and what kind of quadratic equation it is used. So when two people are catching or throwing ball, so the quadratic equation is different, and different in the sense it is part of the bigger quadratic equation. And when the ball, and this is the scenario where the boy learns to catch the ball. Okay, so all behind all these things, there is a mathematic. Now let us try to formally define what is algebra. Okay, so the part of mathematics in which letters and other general symbols, okay, represent, are used to represent numbers and quantities in the form of formula and in the form of equations. So I have shown you a very simple equation. You can see here that there is a variable that is called as x. Okay, so if yesterday's lecture was philosophy expressed in terms of symbols and numbers, so we can see that there is some objective behind this 4x minus 7 equal to 5. Okay, so now in this, if you try to zoom and see this equation, we can see that there are constants, okay, and there are coefficients, there are also variables and some operators associated with these numbers. And now important observation is that how 7 came, how 5 came, how 4 came into the equation. Okay, so we have to think that we have to start thinking that what is the meaning of this coefficient, what is the meaning of this particular constant. Okay, how we come. So this is a best example for us for us to say that before designing an equation, we try to understand the problem and we try to formulate the problem in terms of a equation. So the next, my next slide is a very, very fundamental slide, which will give you a brief idea that how we human beings, also the machines, how they conceive the logic and they use the logic for prediction, okay, for the recognition. So now we can see that, see, this slide is very much related to my previous slide, that I have asked a question that how did we get 4, how did we get 7, and how did we get 5 here. Okay, so this is possible by learning. Okay, so the learning, the word learning is called as cognition. Okay, so the cognition word means we are learning from the environment, we are learning from the data, we are learning from the evidence, we are learning from the observation. Okay, so now how to mathematically algebraically model the model a particular problem or formulate a particular problem into an equation. Okay, so let us see how does a human brain does. So human brain, when it looks the data, when it observes the data, it's okay, the data is in the form of values, abilities, skill, maybe some numbers. Okay, and with that, it starts learning. Okay, it starts learning and then it tries to make decision, opinion, and it makes new memories. So I would like to give you one basic example here. Now today, many of them are seeing my face for the first time. Okay, they are listening to my voice and they are looking at my the way I am actually, I have arranged my slides, the way I am talking. Okay, so now with every dimension, with my face, with my voice, with my actions, you are cognizing about me. That means you are learning about me. Okay, so now once you have learned about me, now next time, maybe after 1 year, I again give this lecture or you meet me in the airport and then you recognize my face. Okay, so now the concept of recognition comes here. You don't do learning there. Okay, you don't do learning there. You now recognize it. That means you recall whatever you had learned. Okay, and moreover, it is not only recalling, but also learning some additional features. Okay, whatever the perspective, whatever the knowledge you had about me, now that knowledge is expanded and you think that, oh, this person also smokes. So this is additional one. Now, okay, so now you can see here, this is the new memories. Okay, now new memories in the sense, you also do cognition, you also do recognition, and also you do relearning. So cognition and recognition will go hand in hand. That means it is a repetitive process. You learn, you recognize, and again the new feature comes, new data comes, then again you learn. Okay, so this is how we make this is how the human being is able to model. Okay, but we exactly, okay, still in the world, scientists are still learning and how this data, the evidence, is organized in the brain. Okay, so there is a separate study on cognition, human brain cognition field. There you can see that many people are doing a lot of research in learning the pattern in which the human learning is stored in the brain and how the cells interact and all those issues people are. So we are not going into that. And now the same knowledge. Now let me rewind it again. See, I asked you a question that how this equation was derived. How these numbers, the coefficient and variables were, they came into picture here. And now I showed you that this is possible by learning. Similarly, that equation which I showed you is also from learning. Now I'll give you a very practical example that how did we learned, okay, how are we learning to convert a Fahrenheit to Celsius temperature and Celsius temperature to Fahrenheit temperature. Okay, so now this is an example. Now the geometrical way of defining, you can see that this is a geometrical way of defining this equation, y equal to 5/9, the slope is 5/9, x minus 18, and this is the another slope. Okay, and now we can see that, okay, so this is derived by looking at the temperature of the the temperature at different points. Okay, and now we, from this geometry, we derive the formula. Right now you might ask a question that how 5/9 came into picture, how 32 came into picture, how and all those things. So now if you clearly understand this geometry, okay, you can easily derive. So this entire picture, okay, this geometry is summarized in the form of this particular formula. You can see that C equal to F minus 32 into 5/9. So now so this is the learning. I learned from this particular scenario, I learned how to convert a given Fahrenheit temperature into Celsius. So now this was cognition. Now what is recognition? Recognition is you put the temperature for F, capital F, and you derive value of C. Or you can do the reverse case. You know, because there is only here there is only one unknown variable on the right side, then you can plug in on on capital F and obtain, by rearranging, you can obtain the this Celsius value also. So now I think you have got the clear idea that given a problem, you need to mathematically model it, and this is a very simple algebraic expression you can see here, okay, and how this is used in solving lot of bigger problems. Okay, so with these three or four slides, I think you got the very basic idea of given a problem, and from that problem, you understand the problem and then understand and represent in the form of a equation, or it is called as a problem formulation. And then from that formulation, you try to do prediction. Okay, you try to do analysis. Okay, all those is possible by this. Okay, now let us come to the next application. Okay, so next application is about the prediction. Same way the previous application was also, previous slide was also about the prediction. How do we predict the temperature for in Fahrenheit if given a temperature in Celsius degree? Okay, so now here is a startup company which actually invests $200 and it earns $150 per month. And now, okay, now it wants to model the profit equation. Okay, it wants to analyze the profit equation that after 12 months or after 2 years, how much profit I will gain, provided the profit remains at the same rate, which is not natural. Okay, the profit may vary as per many parameters. However, to simplify our life, we made that profit is constant. So $150 per month, which is okay, per month in the sense it is X. Now, what is the profit I gain, which is the profit which I gain should be subtracted from my initial investment, and then I can use to predict my profit. So this is a very fundamental application of algebra, okay, prediction. And so in reality, it is not only one parameter, there might be many parameters in the equation, so which in real life they try to solve it. Okay, now we learned how to formulate a equation, how to formulate a particular equation. Now these equations are part of our day-to-day life. Now I have shown you three examples here. Now this is an example where in our day-to-day life we usually do jogging. Okay, so now when you can do jogging on the machine, on the treadmill, or you can do jogging on the ground or anywhere, but you try to calculate that how much distance I have covered, right? How much distance I have covered. Maybe you note down the initial time and you note down the final time, and also you note down how much steps you take per minute or per hour, per second, and based on that you try to calculate the number of steps. And also this machine, you can see that this machine is full of formulas. Okay, it calculates what is the time and what is the speed you are running, and also it will give you the formula for predicting the calories which you have burnt. Okay, the calories which you have burnt. And there is also option for you to increase the elevation, decrease the elevation, and try to burn the calories based on that particular program. Okay, so life is full of mathematics. Similarly, like I am living in Allahabad, so I can see that many people in Allahabad is surrounded by many villages. So people from different villages, they try to bring milk to the city with different measurements, okay, with different measurements, and they try to sell it. So without knowing that this is equation, okay, this is equation, they try to solve their problem, right? They try to solve their problem. Like in I came to know that in summer there is actually very the cow gives very cow or buffalo gives very less milk. Okay, so how do they, because and the number of customers are fixed, so how do they actually adjust their milk, and how do they manage giving milk to the fixed number of customers when the production is very less? Okay, so all those optimization problems are here. Okay, the other example which you can see is that is about the traveling. Okay, so whenever we want to travel, like for example you want to travel to the city from your place, or travel to some destination, so you usually put it in the Google, you select the source, you select the destination Google map, and then you try to calculate what is the time. So it is a very simple mathematics. You know the source, you know the destination, you know the path, right? and you get the distance. However, the time is not dependent of that. The time is not very directly dependent upon the distance, because the time to reach the destination is also dependent upon the congestion in the road, maybe, and the number of signals and the and different parameters. Okay, so now our life is full of formulas. So the next slide I have put is that this is a slide which says that all the data entry job, okay, the all types of job related to data entry are full of algebraic equations. Okay, it is made addition, multiplication, and it is formulating different expressions. Also seeing this different statistics here. Okay, you can see that I need to visualize. So there are three important things which you should remember when you are dealing with the data. Number one is the data analysis, and the number second part is data visualization, because our visualization capacity is limited. If I show you huge number, simple Excel sheet containing 1,000 or 1 lakh rows and tell you to analyze that one, it is not possible for us to analyze. So we have simplified our life by designing different solution for that. So we try to analyze all those things by simple picture, by simple mathematics. We try to do prediction. We try to do we simplify our life. Okay. So data entry jobs are full of algebraic equations. So another simple equation, application of algebra is that calculating the interest. Okay. Calculating the interest. So this is the formula which you can see that this is the principal this is the principal amount, and this is this is the R is the rate of the interest, and with this simple equation we are able to find out what will be the interest. Okay, the bank calculates and it tries to deposit in the account. Okay, so this is a very simple example of using simple algebraic equations to make our life very simple. Okay, so now we learned that algebra is about equations, algebra is about solving numbers, algebra is about solving some simplifying our life. So now algebra is also a skill. Okay, I will explain this with this example. Now you have suppose in the morning you lock your house and you go to your office, and when you and you do all kind of activities means in the office and evening while you return home, you see that the key is missing in your pocket. Okay, the key is missing in your pocket. Now see, you whatever may be the case, either you have lost the key, either you have left out the key somewhere, either someone has stolen, but you need to enter the house. So that is the main objective. You have to enter your house because you cannot stay outside. So now once you are here and you realize that you have lost the key, now you start backtracking. Okay, your mind starts backtracking that, okay, whole day what did you do? Okay, where you went, which all places you went, and you start tracing back each and every main points. Okay, the main point. Suppose you had gone for some shop to purchase something, then you remember there, and then you try to recollect that whether I have left the key in the shop or in my office or in my car or somewhere, right? So the object, solving this problem is an algebraic skill. We try to use numbers. Okay, we try to use time. We try to correlate the time with the numbers, right? So different mathematics is different types of mathematics is used here. Like for example, one type of mathematics which I can tell you is the backtracking algorithm. If you are already aware that I come home and realize that I have lost the key. Now I need to backtrack. So backtrack, I think yesterday sir showed you, Professor Nagbhushan sir showed you the tree, right? The tree, a binary tree where the sir was telling that the ant is moving from one branch to the other branch. okay, following the path. Okay, so now it fetches the food and it tries to remember what path it followed. So this is a kind of a backtracking algorithm. This is a tracking. This is a backtracking strategy it tries to use. So different. So how to represent backtracking is again a question. So now you need to think more about that and try to solve. So now, however, it may be either to get the key. If the person gets the key, he will enter the house. If the person does not get the key, he will break the lock and he will enter the house. So overall, algebra is a skill to solve any problem. Okay. And also coming to the next slide, algebra is also a skill, right? We try to solve our problem and we try to optimize our problem, not only just solving, but also optimizing. I give you an example suppose your mom gives you 500 rupee and asks you to buy tomato, potato, beetroot, onion, and carrot, these five items. However, in this case, the important point is that given 500 rupees fixed and you don't know the rate of tomato, you don't know the rate of potato, but whatever is there, you should buy all these things within 500 rupees. Okay. So you have made assumption that all these five items I can buy within 500 rupees, right? So when you go to the market and you try to ask what is the rate of onion, then I think we had a very, a bad situation a few months back or 6 months back, that onion was very expensive. It was 250 rupees kilo, right? So now if such scenario comes, see, if you want to buy 1 kg of onion is very, very important. So if you buy onion 1 kg, then you should optimize other things. Okay. So it is, the problem here is which one to buy, which one to give more importance and how much to buy. Okay. So all these are different challenges which we try to do in our brain. Okay. Which we try to do in our brain. Now, so our brain automatically uses all these mathematics, all these complicated things it does easily. Now the question is that, can it be mimicked? Can it be done with a machine? Like for example, yesterday Professor Guru sir was talking about that we are moving towards robot. So now the challenge is that you have a robot at your home and you tell the robot that I'm giving you 500 rupee. You hand 500 rupee to the robot and say that you want to buy tomato, potato, instruct him to buy all these five items. Okay. Now that robot has to do all those things, all these optimization and then get you all those five items. He should not miss any item and he should optimize all those things. So using a robot to buy all these things is a challenge there. Okay. And this problem is full of algebra, full of learning, full of cognition, full of recognition. So now you please relate my previous slides. It is all, life is all about learning. And learning is actually learning parameters, learning optimizing, learning the coefficients, learning the constant values in the particular equation. Okay. So another important example which I want to give you is the application of playing. I think this was a very famous game a few years back. Everyone was playing Angry Bird. Okay. So now this is also, you can see that this is very systematically designed. You can see that there is a vector here. There is a trigonometry here. There is some kind of analysis like area of a rectangle, area of a square. So all those kind of problem, and there are angles, right? So now you can, and also the important challenge here is the size of the bird and the weight of the bird. And so yesterday I was, few days back when I was preparing this slide, I was seeing that what is the importance of the weight or the size of this bird. See, it is very, very important because force, here there is a catapult where you need to place the bird and pull it and then you have to shoot the entities here, they shoot the objects here. However, the challenge is that different objects for different mass, objects of different mass, the pulling is systematically determined. Okay, how much you have to, how much the catapult we have to put, pull it is all dependent upon the mass. So the force exerted on a particular object or particular bird is dependent upon the mass into acceleration. Okay, so this is, so this is a slide where you can really enjoy, right? You really enjoy mathematics. Okay, and you would really appreciate that the same technology is used in what you call the missile science and the building of different defense system. See, the same technology, same formulas are used. So I have one slide on that. Let me discuss on it later on. Okay. So this is one example where actually mathematics is used in sports. So I think now this slide will give you much more information, because Professor Nagbhushan sir covered this slide yesterday. Means he gave you an example that how trajectory of the ball is mapped into a quadratic equation. Okay, and how the quadratic roots, the roots of the quadratic equation play a very important role in the sports. Okay, so sir gave the example of football, right? So how the football is, how the person is bending his body and hitting the ball to the goal. Okay, and you can see that there is a two trajectory. The trajectory of the means the shape of the body shape of the person and the trajectory of the what the ball. So they are, so sir asked that whether there is any correlation between these two trajectories. So you can see that mathematics is everywhere. Okay, so you see the football, the basketball player or throwball player. Okay, he does not know. Okay, without knowing the mathematics, he is trying to perfect himself. So he, see how he does. So one important thing is that it is not possible. Suppose you start with any game, it is not possible for you to start. Okay, to immediately become a very successful in that particular game. So meanwhile, when you practice and practice and practice and practice in a perfect way, in a right way, then you realize that if I push this ball with this particular strength, with this particular parameter, then it is going to enter into the basket. Okay, so mathematics is, so by practicing, we are learning the parameters which are required for this equation to do our task. Okay, same way the cricket is also so I was just going through the internet, then I found that the speed of the ball, like for example, we see that when the fast bowler balls and the batsman is he needs to like for example, we have watched Sehwag playing the cricket. So we can see that the whenever the ball speed is very high, you need to just move the face of the bat and just hit the, so the ball is goes to the boundary at a very quick pace. So all those is mathematics. And also we know that for the spin bowler, we need to apply lot of force and lot of trick, because the ball is rotating and the force exerted on the bat, maybe I have to apply more force. Similarly, see, in the same sense, in athletics, okay, in gymnastics, everywhere, it is, the life is full of mathematics. Okay. Now, since you are all mathematics teachers, okay, so now when you are being a teachers, actually when we teach students, see, the you should tell that, see, nowadays many students, they have in their life, they have only two options. They say that either I will go for engineering or either I'll go for medicine. Okay, either I'll become a doctor, either I'll become an engineer. So see, life is not life is not simple. Okay, so now we need to make sure that our students know the importance of mathematics that is been used in different fields. Okay, so sir gave you yesterday, he gave you a lot of examples, like the I can recall, because sir's lecture is simplifying my objective today. He gave the problem of sliding ladder. So sliding ladder is an example for this physics problem. And also he gave a lot of problems, like in differential equations, he gave a lot of problems which involved mathematics and also the physics. And you can also see that the chemistry is the one, the other branch which uses the mathematics a lot. Like how much portion means how much amount of chemical is to be added for a particular reaction, okay, react to take place. So similarly, the biology. So nowadays we have computational, biomedical engineering and all those things are happening because of this huge mathematics behind this biology and also computer science. Computer science, yesterday Professor Guru sir already explained you that how intelligent computing is being popularly using mathematics, okay, arts and culture, all engineering streams, law, business, everything whichever exists uses mathematics, either knowingly or either unknowingly. So you should see whenever we are, so in our career, if you want to know that means if you want to make a very good career in our life, then we should realize that we should become strong in analyzing mathematics and also applying mathematics such a way that we grow, means our professional career is very bright, okay. And yesterday sir told you that mathematics is only discoveries, it is not invention. This when you know how to discover the things, the invention will happen automatically. So it is a responsibility of our teachers to kindle the love for mathematics in the students and motivate them and drive them to solve all kind of problems, whichever field they are. Let them use the basic mathematics. Now I think, see, if the student knows only, see, I have not gone to complex numbers, I have not gone to any other topic, I am explaining you only with algebra. So if the student is very good in algebra, in framing, formulating the problem, in formulating the equations, then his future is bright, and that is in our hands. So we should try to kindle the love for mathematics in our students, because their career, their professional development is directly proportional to the knowledge and the philosophy of mathematics he has gained in his school or the college career, college days. So another, yesterday this comment was there. Yesterday when I was listening to Professor Nagbhushan's lecture, someone had commented that in the chat box that women, okay, in the kitchen, they do a lot of mathematics without knowing the mathematics, that they are using mathematics, okay. So this slide tells that how they are using mathematics. Now the question is that you have to cook, and now the next question which will come to your mind is that what to cook and how much to cook, how many people you want to serve, and if the number of people is known, then actually what is the recipe to select, what is the ingredients, and what is the ingredient in the sense how much quantity each ingredient to be added. So every recipe is a formula, every recipe is a standard formula, okay. So now if you are cooking in the kitchen, that means you are following a particular formula, that recipe is a systematic formula, okay. So now with this, now some people they see the YouTube and they try to tweak the formula, they try to add some more ingredients. So that is how the discovery and the creativity comes into the kitchen. Like many I have seen many YouTube videos where people try, my wife, she prepares a omelette called as eggless omelette. Omelette called as eggless omelette. So we usually omelette for us, it is with egg, right? But she learned from YouTube that you can also prepare an eggless omelette. So how it is possible? So she tried to mix some besan and some all those kind of thing, and you can see that it is the look of the eggless omelette is same as the omelette, okay, egg omelette. So now see, that is how the invention will happen, That is how the creativity will happen. So basically, when you are modifying the cooking formula, it is you are playing with the formula. Same thing should happen in our real life. Same thing should happen with our students. Now, coming to the next application is computer programming. So computer programming is nothing but actually it is development of softwares. The program is possible through the usage of softwares, right? So behind the software there is a mathematics. Okay, behind the software there is a lot of other. So if you want to become a very good engineer, like the people say that I took computer science because there is no mathematics. Okay, it is wrong, because I heard that. Okay, I heard from many bright students, okay, who are placed in Google and who are placed in very Facebook and all big companies. They finally, after their graduation, they come and tell us that, sir, in the Facebook, in the Google, it is only mathematics which is going to help us there. It is the knowledge of data structure. It is the knowledge of algorithms. It is the knowledge. See, please remember, data structure is also mathematics, and algorithm is also mathematics, and also the graph theory is also mathematics. So now, when you know mathematics very well, you can program very. Your program is not lengthy. Your program is very crisp, and it is summarizes within a particular formula. Okay, so no, knowledge of mathematics helps you in designing a very crisp and very competitive code. Okay, same thing applies to hardware. So hardware, you know that the there are programs which are called high level programs. High level programs is C language and all those programs, and also there are many hardware based computing which needs to be done, and all those they use basic algebra. Okay, so they try to use the basic algebra in software as well as the hardware. So now, till now we saw that we are only we talked about only human beings and how to add intelligence to the machines. Okay, whatever intelligence the human being have, we are trying to cognize or recognize using the machines. So I think, hope you remember yesterday's Professor Guru sir's lecture. So in that he showed one slide where he showed that the police is training, means the different animals were trained for different purpose, right? So now this example is that it is not that only human beings are doing algebra, the animals also do algebra. Okay, so this is an example of a flying disc. So once you so first time when you throw the flying disc to the dog, what happens is that the dog may miss it. Next time he may again miss it, but third time the dog's brain calculates that, okay, how much how far the person is standing and when he is throwing and when I should jump and when I should catch that particular flying disc. All mathematical calculations, all algebraic calculations is done in the brain of the dog, and the dog also does the algebra. So how it is possible? So yesterday you saw that there were many applications. Sir used the example of a horse. Sir used the example of a donkey and all those. So it is not that human being, but animals also do algebra. So those were some of the real time applications. Okay, those were very general. Now let us try to cover. Okay, let us see some of the research issues which we have tried to solve. Okay, so I come from an image processing background, pattern recognition background. Now I show you a very simple research application which uses very simple what we call a very simple algebraic expression, algebraic formula to solve some problems. Okay, now this is a board. Okay, now this is a white board on which you are writing some formula. However, here on the top of the board there is a tube light, or there is a light source. So when you take a photo of that particular board, what happens is that since there is a light source, and you will see that there is a gradient, and there is a gradient form, there is a gradient of shadow which is formed, and then it becomes completely dark here, and the formula whatever you had written is not visible. Okay, Now you need to, you have taken an image, you have taken your mobile phone and taken a photo of the formula which was written on the board. Now the question is, you have to recover this formula from the particular photo which you have taken through the mobile phone. How it is possible? It is possible. See, it is possible. Like this is, see, now you take a photo of the same board without writing the formula. Okay, that this is the image B, taking a photo without using, without a formula being written on the board. Now what you do is that this is, now you have taken a taken a photo of the equation, okay, and this is the photo of the board without equation. Now just simple difference between image A and image B will give you this image. It is just subtraction of image A. I think yesterday Dr. Pradeep sir explained you taking two matrices and also how to add two matrices, how to subtract two matrices. So this is just adding, okay, corresponding element A of I comma J, subtracting from A of I comma J minus A of B of I comma J. Okay, so subtracting this element, this value, like yesterday sir explained you that you have some intensity value. That means the intensity value of the image is stored in the matrix, and that intensity value is subtracted from this one. Now obviously this is black, this is white, so now you will get a difference here. Okay, so now image A minus image B gave you this particular image. Okay, now you convert the image. Yesterday sir told you about histograms. Dr. Pradeep sir, histogram is one side it is white, another side it is black. Okay, so 0 is white and 255 is black. Okay, so now you want to convert this one. So there is a simple operation, negation operation. So now wherever there is negation is very simple operation. Wherever there is a black, you put a white pixel. Wherever there is a white, you put a black pixel. So that is how you got. Wherever there was a black, you got white. And wherever there is a black white, you got black here. So we have recovered. So simple difference operation from mathematics is used to recover the formula which was not visible to the human eye. Okay, this is very interesting example. Now here there are two important, one very important thing to remember here. This was your original image, this was your reference image. Okay, the reference image means you had, okay, like for example, you had the option of taking the photo of the board without the expression being written on the board. Okay, now this may not be possible always. So now how to recover this equation without this image being available? So only one image is available. How to extract this equation from this particular image? How it is possible? Okay, so at IIIT Allahabad, one of our UG students tried to develop a very simple formula, a simple algebraic formula, and he has solved this problem. Okay, he has done, like for example, this is a noise, this black portion is a noise. So now he has done is that he has devised some formula to calculate the amount of noise which is to be added to this. So usually what we say that adding a noise to an image or adding a noise to anything is bad for the image. But in our research, we have shown that if this reference image is not available with this particular image, if I use the physics principle called as stochastic resonance. So stochastic resonance is a physics. Okay, it uses physics phenomenon where you excite a particular atom or you excite a particular pixel by supplying some external energy. Okay, external energy is in the form of a noise. So we have done this. I have a slide on that. I will try to give you the reference and also I'll give you two. But the problem is very much relevant here, so I try to explain it here. So the next example here is actually about adding two matrices. So yesterday Pradeep sir gave you that this image can be taken as a form of a matrix one. This is a matrix two image. Okay. So now, how to add these two matrices? When you try to add these two matrices, what happens? So now here is an example. I have written a very simple formula: x into p, 1 minus x into q. P is the first image, first matrix. Q is the second matrix. Now I apply, now I take x equal to 0.8. 0.8 means the amount of numbers, the amount of data which I'm taking from this is 80%, and I'm taking 20% of data from this one. Now you see this resultant image. See, resultant image is 80% of this data, 20% of this data, and it gives you a very nice. So now in through this image, you can see that this is more dominant here, right? Now the other way, let us do the other way. Let us take x equal to 0.2, where this is less dominant, this is more dominant. This is the image you try to see. Now see, now I want to tell you here, the message is that using a simple algebraic equations, it is possible for us to add two matrices, add two images, and the addition of two images, subtraction of two images plays a wonderful role in Photoshop in different types of imaging tools. Okay, so I would little bit go a little bit faster because already 1 hour is over. So because I have to cover complex numbers and also the theory of equations. So now this is another example which I want to show. Now I have given you here addition of two matrices, subtraction of two matrices. Now let us try to, this is a typical answer sheet. Okay, so in IIIT Allahabad, we are trying to automate. Okay, and one more thing which I, one more point, I missed to say that when I had shown you that COVID-19 slide, actually I missed to say that a very, very important point. Okay, see, with the emergence of COVID-19, what has happened is that the world is thinking about more digitalization and more automation. Okay, so now since this application is related to digitization, I remembered that point, and I would tell you here that the world is post COVID era is going to move towards more digitization and more automation. Okay, so one important aspect problem is that the digital evaluation of the answer scripts, because we don't want COVID to be spread through the through these answer sheets. Okay, through this, because and also we cannot tell all the teachers to assemble in a particular room and then do the evaluation. Now it is not practical, it is not feasible nowadays. So now the important solution is, now you have to do digitization of these particular answer scripts. Okay, in digitization of the answer scripts, the very important application is that you need to do restitching or destitching of answers. Okay, like for example, a student may write answer 3B, which is in this page as well as in this page. Okay, so now, but I want answer 3B to be together. I don't want two into two pieces. So this is a, now you can see that this is a matrix. This whole answer sheet is a matrix. This is a matrix B. This is matrix C. So from this matrix, suppose I want to, I want answer 3A, okay, to be segmented or to be removed. So I would take, cut this matrix from this particular row to this particular matrix, and I store it as a 3A. And now same time, now I want to separate question number 6A. You can see here 6A is spillover into the other page. So now this matrix should be brought back and restitched into this matrix. Okay, you are getting the problem, I hope. So it is basic matrix, okay, addition of, okay, it is only appending of rows and appending of columns. Okay, and this simple problem means this simple operation, algebraic operation on matrices, tries to solve a very bigger problem. And now the advantage is that, a very advantage is that, suppose the math teacher, suppose a teacher who is very expert in 3A, 3A means it is on set theory. So I would send these all set theory questions to the set theory teacher. Okay, so, and also this digitization will actually reduce the human effort. Okay, it will reduce the human effort in the sense automatic evaluation will happen, and also error will be reduced, because a teacher, when he in the examination in the evaluation hall, from morning till evening they do the same evaluation, and it is they are looking at the books, they get tired, and then due to some problem they try to put the marks from maybe this question, marks maybe put in the the answer, the marks of this question is put in some other question. Okay, so that human error will happen. So this problem will also, this solution will also reduce the human error. Okay, so this is a very important application which we are working on, and we have students. So this is the answer sheet taken from our students at IIIT Allahabad. You can see that it's a very interesting answer sheet. Okay, so now there are many challenges. I don't want to go into all those things. And see here. So the other important issue is that the student may write the question number 6 first. Question number 1 he may write the last. So now see, use of algebra, use of simple numbers, that is sorting of numbers, and I am sorting all the answers which the student has written, and then I am actually removing all those questions, all those answers which were not answered by the student. Okay, so this is a step towards the more digitization. Okay, so another important this is a very important slide. We had Professor Gaurav Sharma at IIIT Allahabad, and I was very fortunate to listen his lecture. He gave the same lecture in IIIT Allahabad, and where he was working for a Xerox company, I think 10 to 15 years back. So he had a problem in the Xerox company. Like, for example, this document is called a see-through document, means the backside of the page is visible in the front side. Okay, the other side, the backside of the content in the backside is visible on the other side. Okay, so this is called as a see-through document. Now it is very important that when you do for digital evaluation, you have to remove this background, because if this background is there, then it will give error. Your OCR, optical character recognition, your system will give error. So now why I brought this slide is that because the principle which is using to solve this problem is physics union mathematics is greater than physics plus mathematics. Okay, so this link is given. You please, because you are all mathematics teachers, I would request you to go through this. This link is given in the slide. I would share the slides, and you can please visit this, how the phenomenon of physics is modeled into the mathematics, and simple algebraic equation is used to solve this particular problem. Okay, how it is done, I'm not going into details because of shortage of time. Okay, we'll go to the other same way here. Okay, this is the text side, this is the image side. So we have to remove the background from this text. Okay, that is objective here. So another very important problem related to the previous problem is the bleed through problem. Okay, bleed through in the sense when the person he makes an impression on the backside of the paper. Okay, you can see this example. This is handwritten, and you can see the colors. When you go for automation, these things create big problem for us. Suppose if some person writes again here, like in examination sheet, if he writes here, see, there will be a superimposition of the foreground with the background, and it will create a lot of problems. Same kind of problems is called as indented impressions. So indented impressions, you can see that the person is writing, and these whatever he writes, it makes an impression on the background of the page. Okay, and we know that this is a very important aspect which is used in criminal crime investigation. Okay, so whenever a person writes a letter, it is very natural that if he uses some paper in the behind, so there will be impression, and that is used as once I had done some literature survey on this one, then I came to know that this problem is heavily used in crime investigation. Okay, so you are generating the text. Okay, now imagine that the person has written 3 to 4 pages, and the impression is made up of, like, you see this example. This example, I think it is overlap of different writings. The person has written on the same page 3 or 4 times. So now the challenge is different. How to extract the contents from that? Okay, so this is all full of mathematics, full of algebraic equations. So the next slide is, now I will little bit proceed a little bit faster. Okay, now this is an image. Okay, so yesterday I think Dr. Pradeep Kumar explained to you that ये गिवन एन इमेज ओके गिवन ए ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट इमेज इट हैज ओनली वन लेयर ऑफ मैट्रिक्स वेयर एज इफ यू टेक ए कलर इमेज हैज थ्री लेयर्स ऑफ मैट्रिसेस मींस दिस इज एनी कलर इन द कंप्यूटर और इज मेड अप ऑफ आर जी एंड बी दिस इज द वेरी raw color format RGB are the three matrices and you can see here clearly that this is the numbers and in Guru sir's presentation he told that these numbers are between 0 and 255 only so a computer manipulates only 0 and 255 numbers and whatever the operation technology that is available is only manipulation of these 0 to 255 numbers so if you are strong with mathematics if you are strong with what we call the formulas or deriving the formulas from these particular numbers only 256 numbers then you are doing a really great job and you are doing solving great problems okay so any application which can be done on the black and white image can be done on the RGB image so another example which I want to give you is about the data compression okay Now, since we are doing more and more digitization, data compression is also very, very important field. Now, I am showing you a very simple matrix, which is made up of 4 rows and 5 columns. Okay. Now, if you know a little bit of linear algebra, you can see that this is a column, this is a column, this is a column, right? And whereas this is also there are two columns, but these two columns are linear combination of this column so c4 is a combination of c1 into 4 and c5 is a combination of c2 and 3 so now you can see that and yesterday I think Dr. Pradeep Kumar said that every number is stored with 8 bits of information okay now if you remove 1 2 3 4 and 8 numbers from this particular matrix and you have something to store this symbol and this number right these two numbers like for example this is row number this is column number 1 column number 2 so instead of 8 numbers you got 4 numbers here okay so now you are reducing these 8 numbers to 4 numbers and you are actually somewhere you are appending it here and then you are trying to do the compression so compression saves lot of memory now I have through this simple what you call algebraic equation I am able to do data compression okay So now let me take a very practical example. This is a TIFF image, same image. You can see the quality of the image. I have shown you the compressed version of this image. This quality of image is very high and the space it occupies is 2.2 MB of space. Whereas this one is the quality is 100%, whereas it uses the JPEG compression. So JPEG uses like in your mobile phones, you have JPEG compression. And you can see 2.2 MB is now just it is 0.5 MB. Okay, it is only 0.5 MB. And did you see any disturbance in the image quality? Absolutely no, because this JPEG compression algorithm works very perfectly. Okay, fooling the human eye. It fools the human eye and it does the compression. Similarly, you can see that I am again going to. Compress it and I'm converting this entire image without losing the information I'm going to compress this and it is just a 40 kb so data compression plays a very major role in our day-to-day life if you are using mobile phones video camera or whatever application surveillance camera we are using data compression okay so everywhere there is a mathematics I think I have explained in the previous slide how mathematics is used So this is the field where at IIIT Allahabad we have a robotics lab and in the robotics lab so these two slides are prepared by my student so Mr. Mehraj he gave me these slides so in this slide you can see that there is a two manipulator there is a two hand for the robot okay this is a two so you can see that there is a lot of application lot of mathematics involved in this particular okay in this particular model and the whole robotics field is full of mathematics if you are bad in mathematics then don't then it is not your field okay similar kind of application is also in radar so in the radar you can see that the signal is sent to the flight or to the object and that the signal is received you can see that red is the signal which is sent and green is the signal which is received so it is based on very very simple formula of speed speed of light, okay, is actually used here, and then we calculate what is the distance from this particular of this object from that from this particular place, okay, this radar. Similarly, my student who is working in self-driving cars, so we have an object called, okay, in the self-driving car we have object called LiDAR, okay, okay, this is a LiDAR object. So LiDAR object, what it does is that it sends a laser light to all the objects around it, okay, it sends a laser light to all the objects around it, and then it tries to okay, calculate what is the depth of that particular object. So you can see that transmitter sends the signal to the object, and it receiver notes the point, and it tries to calculate the distance. So this is how the autonomous or self-driving car in future are going to work in this. So the reason which I put it here, because this is also a simple algebraic equation which is used to measure the depth of the object when the car is moving, when the car without a driver is moving. Okay, so we are we at Triplet Allahabad, we are doing research on this particular area. And now, excuse me, and now I can give so this is a slide which shows you that when the car is moving and how LiDAR point cloud is used to detect different objects. Like you can see that here there is a here there are some street poles, and here there are street lights, and here there are cars, here there are people moving, and here there is a some what we call, there is a circle, and there are two roads. We can see that the cars are standing, and all those inference should be done from this LiDAR device. How this is possible? By using simple algebraic equations. So there are a lot of applications. So there are also this the what we call the simple mathematics is also used in what we call in modeling objects. So I'm not going to explain in detail, just to give you the idea that 3D modeling of any, like when the flight is designed, when the car is designed, anything which is designed is based on